Please, Kamina, don't do this. I'll do anything, anything, I swear!
How long until the pirates are back in range?
Hour, maybe two, depending on burn. Same as last time.
The time before that.
And the tin time before that.
How are you doing?
I'm not the one we need to worry about.
Her body can't heal under this burn. Even Khan needs to rest sometime.
You'll figure something out. I know you will.
Motherfuckers! Shouldn't be possible! ETA, 8 minutes! They must have increased their burn this time.
Don't these Pashangwalas rest?
Humans rest. Pirates? Are fucking animals.
We need to do something about your arm. Virgil has the medbay prepped and ready.
It's fine. Hardly hurts anymore. We're outgunned and nearly out of fuel. Unless we come up with a plan to shake them soon, infection's gonna be the least of my problems. There is no good option. Whatever you choose will be wrong. And it's your fucking job to choose, Captain.
Coordinates, 8214. What are we looking at?
Fuck if I know.
It's a ship's graveyard. Debris field. Caught in orbit around that body.
There's nothing registered there.
How do you know?
Back when I was MCRN, there were reports of a proxy battle right around here with UNN forces. Never confirmed, but seemed legit.
Or much more likely, it's some solar backscatter, radiation cluttering, or any other fucking thing.
How large was this battle?
Large enough for a pissant ensign like me to hear about it. I'd guess nearly a dozen ships.
New plan. We run for cover in there.
Won't work, boss man. Even if we break their lock, they'll be able to track our drive plume.
There won't be a drive plume. We burn hard for here first, then cut engine and turn into orbit. Let it carry us around until we land in the debris.
Slingshot, fuck yes!
Could work, if there is actually something there.
Stations! Khan, on my word, loose a PDC volley, then turn and burn.
Ah!
It's your turret!
You did it, Boss Mang! Fucking legend!
Quiet!
Alright. No, no. It's not good for you, no.
We don't have much time. The pirates are searching for us, and we can't run again without more fuel and reaction mass. Arlen?
Baratna and I will head out and start scanning.
Captain, I'm prepped for surgery as soon as Khan is ready.
Tell that waste of oxygen. I wouldn't be needing surgery if he didn't freak out the first time.
I'm still here.
Virgil's our doctor. He's what we have.
The prosthetic is ready. Is the, patient?
Fine. But you're staying to make sure Dr. Dipshit doesn't cut off the wrong arm.
Scanners aren't picking up any signs of fuel.
Keep looking. Meantime, I'll go for their reaction mass. What a mess. What got Earth and Mars so worked up?
And what's a Belta ship doing in the middle of it?
Who knows? Hopefully they all got some reaction mass on board, though.
Damn. The blast doors to the Laguna are locked down. Not sure if there's a way to open them.
Always a way through, if you got enough explosives. Go, check out the other ships. I'll see what I can rig up.
You want to use explosives to blast through a blast door? Guess that could work.
Even tell which ship is which. It's all blasted to Falota.
There's definitely more scrap here than a few ships can account for. Maya was right. This was a full-on proxy battle.
With a Belta ship at the center.
Rayan, how's the new prosthetic doing?
Sometimes it feels just like my old leg. But then sometimes it feels like it's the stranger who won't let go of me. And then it starts itching so bad.
Quit whining. You made the right call, Cap. Ray wasn't using his leg much anyway.
Found some reaction mass.
Toss it to me. I will store it. Nice toss, Cap! Woo!
Boss man, you probably noticed me Baratna's been a little edgy lately.
Ray. Your brother has been an angry Pashang Wallow since my first day on board.
This is different. He's got the shakes. It's the pixie dust. But he's been clean for almost a year. He takes some meds that help keep him straight, but...
But we haven't done a supply run in weeks.
Yeah. Ran out of toxiperidone 3 days ago. Don't worry, boss man. He'll be fine. He's tough. But thought you should know.
The Martian ship had focus drugs on board. Must have wanted to question someone.
I hate those things. Rayon and I got busted by the MCRN once. Didn't think I'd leave that interrogation room alive.
Watching that Martian's eyes go all weird. Last time we ever stole anything on Vesta, had to move to Ceres and start stealing there.
Roger will probably appreciate these mushrooms.
Oh, maybe he'll make white kibble when we get back.
Cap, what do you think of Virgil? You trust him?
Not sure. I don't know what Cox was talking about in the mess hall, and Virgil doesn't seem willing to talk about it.
Not willing to talk, or not willing to talk to Beltas?
Might be able to rewire this guidance system to work with our ammo.
It was good enough for Earth and Mars to tear each other apart.
And neither side surrendered, even after taking heavy fire.
Stupid Inyas, they never know when to quit.
Don't want to interrupt, but how is everything down there?
The auto dock was amazing. I want to high-five it, but it's still covered in some really
Maya's always complaining about the tools in the engineering bay. Maybe an MCRM model would cheer her up.
Yeah, Cap. Cheer up the Martian girl with your tool.
Pashang Fong. So the MCRM was chasing the Beltas because they stole something.
Only need one ship to chase someone. Why'd they bring a whole fleet?
The Martians were embarrassed that a group of Beltas got to their security. Racist shits.
And they reacted the way they always do. With guns.
Hopefully won't need these anytime soon.
After this week, maybe keep them close by.
Maya? Status report?
Fire the torpedoes! Give those sons of bitches a welcome, or I'll throw you in the brig!
Sit down, or I'll cut off the other arm! Sorry, Cap, what was that?
Is that Khan? Why is she so angry?
Something about bogeys on the radar? She's a little woozy from anesthesia. I hope she passes out again. I'm gonna draw on her face.
Ugh. And Inyas say that Belta food is disgusting.
Real Earth whiskey. Even Cox has to settle for the Belta stuff.
Earthers love their oceans. Too bad they destroyed them all. Is everything,
Okay, she just said we've been boarded. And now she's wandering around looking for intruders. So, everything's fine.
Maya, this is Khan we're talking about. No one knows what she's capable of. You need to hide.
First of all, fuck you. Second of all, she's gonna hurt herself if she... Wait. Hey there! Do you wanna lie down for a minute?
Do you wanna fucking die?!
Damn, she's going crazy.
Oh no.
Khan looks possessed. She looks...
Must be the captain. Very proud of his connections to the UN and brass. Whatever the Belta stole, the UNN and MCRN both went after it.
But how did this turn into a shootout?
Mars couldn't stand the loss of their tech, and the UNN couldn't resist the chance to get their hands on it.
Good work, Sasata.
Boss Mang, I got everything hooked up to blow the door. Head back to the Laguin and check it out.
Got it. Hopefully we'll find enough reaction mass to get out of here.
And then what? We going treasure hunting?
Yeah. You think those coordinates go anywhere interesting?
Cox said those coordinates were valuable. But Cox started talking just to get out of the mess he made.
Good thing you shut him up, Sasuke.
Explosives are set.
Good work, Kamina. Now let the whole station see what happens to traitors who sell out the OPA to the Inyas.
I'm in.
I'm still looking for that laser. I want to see if this laser crystal is somewhere in the ship.
These boots might fit Khan. Once I get the feet out of them.
Oh. Yeah, feet are a good sign. Means they work.
Gotta be something in here that can help Arlen. Another blast door.
Pshing. Fine, I'll get more explosives.
No need. I should be able to access the lockdown controls from the bridge.
Good thinking, Cap. Could still find more explosives. Just in case.
Yalik Pashang! If there's one thing all belters can agree on, is that the moldy filters kick ass.
Please tell me you're still alive.
Okay. Con and I had to trade a few punches, but we got her calm enough to attach the prosthetic. Aw, were you worried about me?
A rampaging pilot on a drug-fueled hallucination? I never doubted you for a second.
Goddamn right. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to find an ice pack.
That went surprisingly well.
Wouldn't let anyone get their hands on that tech. Good for them. Looks like the crew tried to record a message.
This message is to all Erda and Martian security forces in the area. We have received your warnings and...
After I wiped the floor with Dawes one time, he declared that Gogo was frivolous and banned OPA from playing. Typical. I'll need to make a hole to pass this to the twins. The static cube hacker might be useful.
Sure, might let you break into Rayon's special data drives.
Set up push toe!
Found another barrel.
Woo! This is loaded! Or whatever the Inyas say.
Here it comes.
Touchdown! Woo!
I've got some radiation from a nearby ship, the Manitoba. Scanner shows the engine is mostly intact. Maybe a few pellets too.
Boss man, that's the far edge of the debris field.
You'll be exposed.
You two head back to the Artemis. Everyone stays on the ship, but be ready to pick me up on my order.
From the Europa's Bane.
Sabaka, they locked us?
No, it's a broadcast. But they must know we're close.
Patch it over.
There is no sense in running anymore. You know who I am, and I am looking forward to meeting you. Contact me to discuss the terms of your surrender. Or just sit and wait until we find you. It's only a matter of time.
Shit, shit, shit! Cap, you got to get back here!
Not without fuel pellets.
Stupid drone is stuck.
Sabaka? I doubt they will all be so easy to kill.
Virgil, if I respond, will they be able to trace the signal?
No, it will only confirm you are in broadcast range. But they seem pretty sure of that already.
Put me through. Captain Zapata, this is Kamina Drummer of the Artemis. I don't want to fight you, but keep sending your crew after me, and I'll be forced to keep killing them.
A long way from Ceres Station, Kamina Drummer.
You've heard of me?
I've heard of your work and your bounty. But if I'm speaking to you, what happened to Garrison Cox?
He attempted to double his profits. As a result, I am now captain.
Not surprising. There's no loyalty among scavengers. Not that the OPA is any better. You must really enjoy the company of miscreants.
You can always retreat, Toussaint. Protect the rest of your crew.
Your reputation is well earned, Captain Drummer. Daniel and Yuri were two of my best. But their needless deaths do not change.
Enough. I've had a very long week in a crash couch because of you. Either fall back or keep sending your men to die. Those are your options. Please tell me this thing has ammo.
I'm on my way.
No! Everyone, stay back! What's happening? Why are the pirates pulling away?
There are always more options, Captain. I'll have the coordinates. Even if I have to comb through rubble to find them. Goodbye.
You're bluffing. Hello? Toussaint! Come on. Gotta be some ammo left.
PDC delivery.
Sabaka, I told you to stay on the ship.
Reprimand me later. Just let me do my job now.
I don't know what the fuck you two are doing, but I'm approaching your location on control thrusters for whenever we shut off.
Glad you're back at your post.
What are you waiting for?
We only get one shot before they know our position. There!
I believe celebrations are in order.
coordinates are set for the MK core. Time to see what all the fucking fuss is about. With the fuel you found, we should have no problem getting there and back to Ganymede at least.
And how is the new prosthetic?
It'll do. Get some rest, Captain. No telling what we'll find at those coordinates.
I've never had anything resembling a civil conversation with Khan before. But I've also never had a cigar to ply her with. Hey, Khan.
Resting. Go away.
Can you believe how vicious these pirates are?
Yes.
I mean, how they were willing to blow us up just to prove a point.
Yes.
So you don't think there's anything special about them?
Yes, I do. They seem to have more guns.
Good talking to you, Khan.
Yeah.
It's been a rough week. I should check in with the crew and see how everyone's doing. Phew, Flota. Cox was even more unhinged than I imagined. I don't see myself drinking a dead man's scotch anytime soon. Maybe if things get desperate. I don't see myself drinking a dead man's scotch anytime soon. Maybe if things get desperate. What are these? Decryption keys? Pushingwala! I knew Cox was paranoid, but spying on his crew? What are these? Decryption keys? Pushingwala! I knew Cox was paranoid, but spying on his crew?
Whoever took Khan's barbecue sauce is a lot braver or stupider than I am. Whoever took Khan's barbecue sauce is a lot braver or stupider than I am.
What's on your mind, Captain?
Cox said you were hiding something. Something that Belters wouldn't like.
I don't mean to speak ill of the dead, but Cox was a habitual liar. First, he tried to murder you. Then he tried to deflect blame onto me.
So there's nothing else you wish to share? Nothing you're hiding?
No, Captain. No more than anyone else on this ship.
Get some rest, Virgil.
Will do, Captain.
Farm that he claimed would be useful in the event of an amputation. Now I'm hoping we have enough for Khan and Rayan. Taking Cox's gun from him was as close to a captaincy ceremony as I'm likely to get. I kept telling Rayan to put that thing away. Now look at it. Saving this containment vault was an awful call to have to make. But without the fuel, ammo, and oxygen it contains, we could end up losing a lot more than just a leg.
The storage? Where's the brig?
It was you? You stole Khan's barbecue sauce?
This could be anyone's sauce. You can't pin it on me. Who are you gonna believe anyway? Me or the crazy old pilot?
The pilot.
Honestly, I'm glad Maya finally got one. This was starting to get sad.
Hey, Cap.
Khan seemed pleased with her prosthetic.
That's good.
Although you realize we just took the most unhinged person on the ship and gave her a bionic skull crusher for an arm.
I think if Khan wanted to kill someone, she could do it without arms or legs. I'll leave you to it, then.
Wait. About that moment in the airlock.
Yes?
Are you feeling any better? I know you were pretty scared, given how tightly you were holding my hand.
I noticed how terrified you were. Must have been your first time facing real danger.
And my first time comforting my terrified captain. I'm here if you need to talk, by the way.
The only thing we need to talk about is your delusion of fantasizing about me.
I get it. It must be hard for the Boss Meng to express her feelings. Especially to the hot Martian engineer who can totally kick your ass.
Not according to that scoreboard.
My point is, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. Even if you did clink helmets with me.
Clink helmets? What is that supposed to mean?
I think you know exactly what it means. Helmet clinker.
Are you trying to kiss? So what?
Let's pretend for a moment that we did touch helmets. So what? You're clearly obsessing over such an insignificant moment. It's sad.
Bullshit. From the look in your eyes, I would have thought helmet clinking was Belter third base. You know, we could stand here talking about hands and helmets all night. Or we could go back to my room and settle it.
I'm confused. Are you still trying to fight me?
Either way, someone will definitely be getting slammed against a wall.
If I sleep with Maya, the entire crew will know about it. Nothing stays secret on a ship like this. Is one night worth all the drama? Sorry, Maya.
Go to sleep, Captain.
Pashang. Are you watching me?
No. Now sleep.
What the hell? There's nothing on the map. No record of any settlements. So what the fuck is that?
Whoa. I collect all the data logs. Nice. The laser crystal that I found aided Karn's surgery. I heard the whole story of Karn's surgery for Maya. I found the cigar, but didn't give it to her. I found medication, but didn't give it to Arlen. Found some mushrooms, but didn't give to Virgil. I just found things, but didn't give them to anybody. Drama spent the night in her own quarters. That's all for tonight. Thank you for watching. This is Sundrop, signing off.